Hello everyone. So I am back with another video on this channel, and in today's video we are going to cover an interview question which is asked by Tekion for front-end engineering interview rounds. And the interview question is like this: we have to implement an event emitter from scratch in JavaScript. So the working of event emitter is like this: we first register an event emitter and we add some listeners to it, like the name of the event for which we want to listen for a particular one, and the callback function which needs to be executed when this event is emitted by the event listener. So first we add event listeners like event1, event2, and we register some callback functions like this. Now the event emitter will emit the event when the event occurs. For example, let's just say you have a listener for a click. So when a particular element is clicked, then the event will be emitted by the event emitter. And when the event emitter emits the event, it will pass on some data, and that data is then executed by the callback function. Now you can also add listeners and you can remove listeners, and you can emit the event from the event listener so that the callback functions which are listening for this event gets executed. So that is the overall working of an event emitter. So a few popular examples of event emitters are having a click listener on button or on a particular div element, and when the particular element is clicked, the event listener is executed, and then we remove the event listeners when the component is done, when the UI is emitted, and at that moment we use the remove listener for a particular event like click. So with that in mind, let's start off with the actual creation part. So first we define a class called as event emitter. So this class will be responsible for handling the events. Then we have a constructor function which will take the construct the events object. So we will have this.events in which we will store events, and this is going to be a JSON object. Then we need to first implement the first method, which is add listener. So add listener takes two parameters. First is event name, and second is the listener itself, the callback function which needs to be executed. So what we can do is we can first check if the particular events class, or the is.events, has that event or not. So we will check whether the this.events has a particular event. If it does not have the event name, then what we will do is initialize the this.events with the event name. That is, we will create an entry of the particular event into our this.events object, and we will assign this to an empty array. Now, what we will do is we will push the listener to this this.events.event name. So this will actually consist of the listener. So we will store the listener within the array which we just created. So this will consist of the listener itself. Then the next function that we need to write is the emit function. So emit function takes two parameters. First is the event name itself, and second is the data. So when a particular event occurs, for example, click events occurs, then the emit event is implicitly executed by the event emitter, and the listeners which are present in a particular event are executed. So we'll write const listeners is equal to this dot events and the event name. So we'll initialize all the listeners. Now event emitters can have multiple events, for example, multiple callback functions. For example, click listeners can have multiple listeners to it. So if that is the case, then we'll execute each of the listeners. So for that, we will write listeners, which is an array dot for each, then the individual listener, and we'll execute the listener function, that is the callback function, with the data. And that is the emit function. After that, we are going to write the remove listener method. So remove listener will consist of the event name and the callback function which needs to be removed. So the particular listener that we want to remove, for example, if there are multiple listeners, then we will remove the particular listeners from the event name. So we write listeners is equal to, again, this dot events. And within that, we will have the event name. Then what we'll do is we'll filter out the listener. So we'll write, okay, this should be an array and not. So the square brackets. And if we have listeners, then what we'll do is in the this.events.event name, we'll filter out the listeners. So we'll write the event name dot filter the listener that we have, and we'll return all the listeners. So okay, this is, so listener, so let's rename this to input listener, and we'll check that the particular listener is not equal to the input listener. That is, we will remove the listener from the listeners array. And that's it from the event emitter from scratch class. Now we'll execute each of this code. So first we'll initialize the event emitter using the syntax, which is const. My emitter is equal to new event emitter, and let's check if there is any error in our code. So we'll check the console, and there is some error at line number 34. So I think this is an implicit method. So we'll take the code inside and check. Now on line number 41, there is some error. So this is filter function. So we'll write it like this. And okay, we shouldn't have a return because we are implicit directly executing the code. And now let's check if there is any error. So I don't think there is any error. So let's move ahead and define our callback function. So the first callback function is a simple callback function in which we take the data and we execute callback one, and the data which is passed to this function. Then we have the second callback function. Again, it has some data and it will execute callback two and the data. Then let's add some listeners like event one with callback one and event two with callback two. Then let's emit some code and check whether the emitters are working fine. So let's go with event one emitter and event two. And as you can see, we have the callback one, which is hello world, getting printed out from callback one function, and event two executing from the event two callback two function. Then let's remove event listeners. That is, we'll remove the callback one from the, we'll remove the listener event one with callback one. That is, we'll remove the callback one from event one method, and then we'll emit the event one again. And emit event one. Now it is saying input listeners is not defined. Okay, this is input listener, so this should be input listener. And now let's check the output. So as you can see, after the event listener is removed, the after removing callback is not getting executed. Similarly, what we can do is we can have multiple listeners in event one class. So let's just say event one consists of callback one and callback two again. So in this case, the output will be callback one will execute hello world, callback two will execute hello world, because both of the listeners are listening on this class. And then the event two callback is getting executed. So hello world from callback one, hello world from callback two, and event two callback two is also getting executed. So this is how you can implement event emitter in JavaScript from scratch. So I hope this video was helpful to you. So thank you and have a nice day. Goodbye. See you all in the next video.